Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Patty Doyle. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Thank you very much. A few words from Ukulele Ike. Anything I can do for anyone? Are you all ready?
Yeah. You're Louis Armstrong. I love that.
You don't do Louis Armstrong.
I like Mr. Right? Periwinkle myself.
Yeah. What'd you say, little girl?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, hello, Dolly.
Thank you. Hey.
Hello, Dolly. Hello, Cheryl Brooks. How are you, my dear?
Let's all say hello to Cheryl Brooks and give her a brisk round of applause. Now, Cheryl, the current champ, she has won $100, won one game, and the time expired just after she won the game, which means that we're going to start with the audience match today, Cheryl, where you can win over $5,000. We wish you the very best of luck in that, and we'll start that right after we finish this. Okay, Cheryl, here we go. Not too long ago, my dear, we had a bunch of people in here. We locked the doors, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Sure blank. Now, the answer they wrote down most frequently is valuable to you. It'll net you $500 if you match it. Then if you match the second most popular answer they came up with, you get $250 and $100 for matching their third most popular answer. And three of the six weirdos are going to help you.
Good. Richard.
Richard, what do you say to that?
I had last week. Sure thing. Yeah.
Sure thing.
Brett?
Sure enough.
Sure enough. Southern Belle expression.
Charles, please.
Sure fire.
Right.
Thank you.
I had dental work.
So there you have sure fire, sure enough, and sure thing. Now, Cheryl, you may choose one of those now or reject all of them and give us one of your own. It's entirely up to you from here on in.
Sure thing.
Sure thing is what Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. The audience apparently agrees with you. We'll find out how right you are and how right they are, too. May we see the $100 response? Surefire is Brett's answer, right?
No, it's not.
Oh, it's
I went through a whole thing, and
I'm sorry.
You are.
I'm sorry, Chuck. Can you find room in your heart to forgive me? Okay, thank you. We are looking for sure thing. So far we have sure fire and one angry celebrity. May we see the $250 number? Sure enough.
That's Charles' answer.
That's Charles' answer, right.
It is not.
It's not Charles there.
Now you have two.
All right. Now we have two unhappy celebrities. Let's see who else we can offend as we reveal the $500 response. Oh, you got it. Congratulations. Congratulations. Now you have a total of $600. And you can play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, Cheryl. And we want to give you that money, but we can't give you the money until you match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, good luck to you, my dear. Get your ESP flowing over to him, and I'm sure you'll come up with the same answer. Here it is. Moment to blank. That's M-O-M-E-N-T. T-O blank. Moment to blank. All right, Cheryl. He wrote down his answer very quickly. You think about it. Give us the answer he's written. We give you $5,000. Moment to...
remember.
Moment to remember. All right, let's find out what Richard has written there. Moment to remember, Richard. She says we'll match it.
I said moment to moment.
Moment to moment, yeah. Yeah, I thought of that first, too.
Living life, moment
but
to moment.
But now that I hear of it, moment to remember is not bad. Yeah, I guess there's some others, too. But it didn't get you the $5,000. You could still get that, though, because you got another game to play here and another person to meet. Here comes Peter Chaconis. You know each other?
Oh, we've met.
You've met backstage.
You bet.
Welcome you, Peter.
Thank you.
And you're Peter Chaconis.
That's correct.
Peter Chaconis, where are you from?
Originally from a little city called Los Gatos, California, but now from Hollywood.
Los Gatos.
Yeah.
That's north of here, isn't it?
That's right.
Yes. What do you do?
I'm a singer.
No kidding.
Yeah.
You're a baritone.
I am.
I could tell.
Well, thank you.
Yes. De la filla del amore.
Show us your...
De la amore. Okay.
I'm Greek, so I...
Oh, you're Greek.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, sing something in Greek.
I don't know a thing.
You don't?
No.
How the hell do you expect to make a living if you can't sing in Greek?
My parents were in deep neglect.
I see. All right, well, good luck to you in your singing career, and good luck to you here, too, Peter. We'll begin by asking you to make a selection. You may have A or B.
I may have B.
You may have B. Ah, bravo, Figaro. Bravo, bravissimo. Carl the Cannibal wanted a square meal.
Yeah.
So, he went to Hollywood and ate blank. He wanted a square meal, so he went to Hollywood and ate blank.
Okay. This is the place.
Yes.
A square meal.
Went to Hollywood and ate blank. Right. Excuse me, I'm a little thirsty.
Grapefruit juice. Very good for you.
Puckers your lips. Got vitamins in it and all that, has it? There. You ready, Brett?
Well, start. Almost.
Here we go.
Get here.
Peter.
Yes.
Carl the Cannibal wanted a square meal, so we went to Hollywood and ate blank.
Who went to Hollywood and ate a TV dinner?
Well, because they come in square.
A square pan.
Yeah, that's right.
They're rectangles.
Are they rectangles?
Well, so.
Look how deeply familiar she is with
them. Right.
I don't want her cooking for me.
Peter, I think you really didn't listen. You must listen here to every word. There were several operative words, such as Carl the Cannibal, you see.
You're only allowed to be called a cannibal if you do eat people.
Right.
Not TV dinners.
Now, Peter, show us your answer, Dick.
Lawrence Welk.
Lawrence Welk. Square. You see, a one,
and a two.
Yeah, all right. Okay.
The girls are really doing well.
What is this? Is this your judgment of her answer?
I don't know. Some man came and put it there.
Offensive answer award. Why is that an offensive answer award?
Well, I haven't seen your answer. How do I know if it's going
to
be offensive?
Give it to him.
Yeah.
Monty Hall.
Well, he is square, and there's no two ways about that.
See that?
What?
Cold and hard.
That's right. Mean, too.
My friend who I love. Whom I love?
Whom you love.
Peter Marshall.
Peter Marshall, the Hollywood Squares. Oh, yes. You see, square.
Squares again, not rectangle.
Right. Okay, Elaine, here we go. Carl the Cannibal wanted a square meal, so he went to Hollywood and ate...
Not that he is a square, it's just his show is... Hollywood Squares. Peter Marshall.
Peter Marshall. All right. Now, what did you say to this?
Well, I think the Lennon sisters are really doing well.
They are, indeed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Lawrence Welk seems to be the definitive answer. Patty?
Oh. Unless you have a certain roommate, Monty Hall.
Okay. All right, Peter, so...
Zippo.
Yeah, you know how the game is played now.
I certainly do now, yes.
You've learned the hard way, Peter. All right, we'll have one for you, Cheryl, right after we do this business with America. All right. Cheryl, this is your first round question, and it reads as follows. Catherine said...
Your girl.
My boyfriend, Tommy, is the world's toughest typist. Just to prove he loved me, Tommy took a typewriter and typed my name on his blank.
I don't know. What's wrong today?
Well, my boyfriend Tommy is the world's toughest typist.
Toughest typist?
Toughest typist. Toughest typist. Typist. Typist.
Now, just to prove he loved me, Tommy took a typewriter and typed my name on his blank.
Doesn't even make sense, that question.
Yes,
tough,
it does.
Tough, tough,
tough. There's one very obvious answer.
There is?
Yeah, there are several good ones.
Yeah, but...
He's a tough typist.
Tough, just... What'd you say?
Anytime, Charles.
I'm trying to think what you can put in a typewriter.
Write something down.
That's good.
Yeah, but then...
What you can't put in a typewriter.
Well, you can put it in better than some other thing.
All right, Shirley, you ready? You've been thinking about it. I'll read it one more. Catherine said, my boyfriend Tommy is the world's toughest typist. Just to prove he loved me, Tommy took a typewriter and typed my name on his blank.
Chest.
Chest. That would mean he'd have to stick his head through the platens.
He's got
to
be tough.
Roll it up. That would be very difficult.
I would say.
It would hurt like heck, wouldn't it?
I think it would hurt much more on his tongue.
Tongue is the good answer, you see. Just to prove he loved me. Now, that's almost within the realm of possibility. What do you say?
I say that question stinks. Tommy had very thin skin, and he could pull it away from his bicep. He put it on his bicep.
On his bicep, then.
One of these days, I'm going to refuse to answer one of those dumb questions.
When is your
Who
next
wrote
session?
That?
You have a session coming up tomorrow, I hope. Get rid of some of your unresolved hostility. Okay, Charles.
Gene, I can't go on this way. Yeah. 5 years I've had it. I thought the question was charming. On Tough Tommy's typewriter, it's tongue.
His tongue. Sit up straight and eat your oatmeal.
Yeah.
Okay, Elaine, we're up to you. Yes. He loved me, just to prove he loved me, Tommy took a typewriter and typed my name on his...
Tongue.
Tongue. That seems to be the answer, Cheryl.
Yes.
There it is. Picture of the tongue right in the typewriter there. Didn't hurt at all, did it? All right, Patty, show us your tongue.
I figured he was really tough.
Yep.
Typed a name on his mother.
Ah!
Tough. That's tough.
Yeah, that is really tough. So there we are at the end of round one, and as all can plainly see, I got plenty of nothing. And you know that song, Peter?
Oh, I do.
Would you like to sing
right
a few bars?
Sing a little of that.
Come on, go.
Yeah, let's hear you.
Oh, you want to hear?
Yeah. Let's hear.
I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me.
Okay. You want A or you want B or
B?
All right. He wants B. Hey. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle said,
"Oh, good."
Well, what else?
Another lousy question, right?
None. Tonight, I had a date with a 17-year-old girl.
Yeah?
She stood me up, and I'm glad. Otherwise, I would have blinked. How old are you?
Any other questions to call over?
You stood me up and I'm glad, otherwise I would have blanked.
Oh, okay.
I'll give it to you straight, Peter. Yes.
Charles.
Charles, what's in the paper, Charles?
Well, it just says Monty Hall is suing Goodson and Todman for $2 million.
Oh, really?
Quite an article.
I'd like to see him try and collect. You're finished.
Of course.
All right.
Of course. Of course.
Okay,
I don't
we're
like
going to Peter Chicanos. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle said, tonight, I had a date with a 17-year-old girl. She stood me up, and I'm glad, otherwise I would have blanked.
Fainted.
Fainted, he said. Just the thought of it, a 17-year-old girl. What do you say?
I say Peter looks like a very famous star. Can't think of his name.
Give us the initials.
Looks like Harry Reid.
He looks like Harry Reid.
Yes. Harry Reid. Yeah. The best actor in Hollywood. Guaranteed.
Harry
Reid.
Oh, look at that.
All right. Here's one to you.
What do you say?
Will I display a dreadful ignorance if I ask who Harry Reams is?
Well, I'm
afraid
don't.
So. Yes.
He's got a very large.
Right. Yes. It's irrelevant.
I'll show you later.
Come on, show your ass.
Well, he said he had to put his teeth in.
I'm glad, otherwise would have had to put my teeth in.
I said croaked, I'm sorry.
He croaked. Now, Peter's looking for the word fainted.
So near, and
I'm glad
so near.
The 17-year-old stood me up, because otherwise I would have fainted, he said. What did you say, Elaine?
I said he would have died.
Yes, that's possible. But if it kills her, it kills her. What are you going to do?
Little did you know.
Expired, all right. Okay, Patty.
Croaked.
Okay, there you are. So you pick up one. That means when we get back from this commercial, you'll need one to tie and two to win. Let's see what happens right after we see about this. Here we go. This is the end, Cheryl.
Yes.
The last question of the final round.
Keene, before we go on.
Yes.
You know, Lawrence Welk is taping in this.
Oh, he's across the hall.
He really is. Yes. And we do lines about him, but he is an institution in America
really
and brings happiness to millions of people. So does Harry Reams, of course, but one at a time. So we love Lawrence.
We love nothing personal, Lawrence.
No, we love him.
Oh, we do love him. And he proved he was absolutely right. When they canceled his show and he went into syndication, he was bigger than ever.
Bigger than ever.
Right.
He's so okay. Was Harry Reams.
Thank you.
Right.
That's easy for you to say.
We digress.
Yeah, let's go.
Shall we stop digressing?
All right. And start undressing.
Susan said, my poodle comes all the way from Paris. He even blanks in French. Do you like my Susan? Do you like my old man Periwinkle? How's my Susan?
I thought it was good.
I think your Susan sounds more like a little sissy.
Susan talks this way. She said, my poodle comes all the way from Paris, even blanks in French.
That sounds like a lot of people I see on Hollywood Boulevard.
No, that's the way Susan talks. See, you women, you lisp.
We do?
Yes, you do.
Listen, not me.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Oh, yes. Oh. All right.
Now, wait a second.
Oh, all right,
come
we'll
on.
Wait. While we're waiting, Peter, is there anything you'd care to say or sing? Because I have a feeling you're not going to be around too long.
I've got that empty feeling inside myself.
I mean, yeah, another half chorus or something. There may be someone watching who can give you a job.
Oh,
will you speak to Charles, Gene? I've done everything, including I told you we need a cattle prod, and you don't get one.
He's making up his mind.
What
all right?
Mind?
Here it is. Susan said, my poodle comes all the way from Paris. He even blanks in French.
Barks.
Barks in French. She said, he even barks in French.
She has won.
There it is. Score is now 1-1. One more rock, and she wins the game. We got a tie score at this moment.
Peter, you're cute. I'm sorry. Barks.
Barks in French wins the game. So won the rest of you. Barks. Okay, come on down, Cheryl. Now, before we dismiss Peter, I just wanted to see what all that writing was about.
Oh, hell.
That showbiz? All right. Peter, good luck to you in your singing career.
Thank you.
Got some gifts coming your way and all kinds of nifty stuff. Wait a minute. Don't go, Peter. Wait and dismiss you. Peter, come back here. Turn that machine around here. I didn't say you could go. Flip that switch. Mark Breslow, you flip that switch. Do what I tell you to. I said flip the switch.
Here he comes.
You sure there's not a half a point left? Goodbye, Peter. While we're here's a little message for you. Hurry back.
He was
here
in
we
God's
are.
Favorite. With
and there we go. That's
a good answer.
Whatever happened to Peter Chaconis? You know the fella kept going around in the thing like that?
He's gone.
Yes.
He fell off.
Yeah. Anything anybody like to do for 35 seconds here? Because I don't know what to do.
I've got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. got my time, I got my fill, I got my sympathy.
What does it say there, Charles?
Wait a minute. Charles will tell you what it says in the newspaper.
You get your Conus signed for the Gong Show in Terminal.
I see. Join us next time for Match Game 77 G Revenue. Goodbye.